Hey guys, it's Chris with The Combo, and we're here with the 950, the Microsoft Lumia 950, one of the very first official Windows 10 phones. We've literally just booted it up. If you've seen our unboxing video, then you'll get to see all that excitement. And now here's our first look at the Windows 10 desktop. Now, so as you can see, it's already quite highly populated with a bunch of Microsoft stuff. You've got your calendar, your mail, Cortana, of course, taking a massive precedence on the desktop there. Microsoft Edge, the new browser, which replaces the Internet Explorer. Certainly seems to be a step up. So if we see, welcome to Microsoft Edge. Just handy little features like being able to catch a brief glimpse of a tab without actually going into it, syncing up your bookmarks with your Windows 10 device at home, all that kind of stuff. It's a nice consistent experience. So it's got Lumia help. I'll start again. We've also got Lumia help and tips, which I'm assuming just shows you the basic functions of the phone. The camera. Let's jump into the camera app and have a quick look at that. Oh, that's all upside down. As you can see, we've actually got a physical camera key on the top here, so obviously it wants it's holding this the right way up. Let's give it access to us then. So there's the camera interface. As you see, nice and simple. We've just got a few little things, such as being able to swap between the front and the rear cameras, flash and is this rich capture. Yep, brilliant. Okay, so that shows that we're on full automatic mode at the moment. And if you want to jump into more settings, you can just do that. And you've got your usual Microsoft lenses and everything, so that's all good. Skip back to the interface, as you can see. Autofocus is always already doing its job. You can have a bit of a spin around there. And if you want to take a shot, well, that seems nice and quick, certainly. So we'll be giving that a full test out in the coming weeks or so, and giving you lots of thoughts on that. Full galleries and everything. Jump back into the desktop. As you can see your photos and everything. Groove Music comes installed as standard, and I believe that's Windows 10 standard, so you get that on your desktops and everything as well. And it's detected, well actually you already said that we were in London, so it's showing us how crap the weather is, shocker. And if we pull down the notifications, you can see that's a much more expanded version of what you used to get on the old Windows Phone 8. So you've got plenty of different things you can do now. Battery saver mode you can chuck on if you're on a bit low, for instance, mobile hotspots, all that kind of stuff. You can boost up the screen brightness nice and easily. Rotational lock will stick on so it doesn't spin around. And as you can see, Windows 10 has already sent us a message to make us feel loved. So just, yeah, how to get started. Well, click on the Get Started app, that's nice and simple. And if we flick across here, as you can see, anyone who's got Windows Phone, it's a nice consistent experience from that as well. You know exactly what to do. You just flick across, there's all of your apps, and of course they're all arranged quite neatly by letter, and hopefully if it's the same as the beta, all your favorite apps will sort of gather at the top there, so you can sort of jump into them nice and quickly as well. As you can see, quite a lot of stuff is installing at the moment. We've got likes of Audible support now, so there are quite a lot of third-party developers who are coming out with stuff for Windows now on the phone. And it should be a consistent experience across the phone and the desktop as well, which is really nice. You know what to get. Netflix is just busy installing. Brilliant, be able to watch more Archer. It's a nice smooth experience as well, thanks to the Snapdragon processor. We jump into the settings as well. This is much tidier than it used to be. Everything is sort of neatly clustered in sort of just nice smart groups, so you know exactly where to expect stuff. If you want to stick one of your accounts in, you can just jump straight in the account section. If you want to fiddle with the display, we can do that. Privacy features, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, so it's all, you know, it's all nice and easy. Just everything is where you'd expect it to be. So that's nice. So that's a sort of a quick look at the Lumia 950 desktop. We've got the 950 XL as well, just busy setting that all up and everything, so we're gonna jump into that bad boy once it's done. If you've got any questions at all about the 950 or the 950 XL, about Windows 10, how the experience is on the phone now, then just give us a shout in the comments and we'll do our best to answer you. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Cheers.